اوكي الحمد لله والصلاه والسلام على رسول الله. النوع الثاني the second type همزه ساكنه followed preceded by a كسره. Again, remember, we're talking about Hamza Sakina in connection. When we're connecting, it's also Sakina. Pay attention here. There's a ya, there is a kasra before the Hamza, and the Hamza is written on a ya. On a ya. And I want you to distinguish between when the Hamza is written on a ya, and when you think it's written on a ya, but it's written on the line, like this word, shay. Shay. See here? In this case, the Hamza is written on the line, not on the ya. As some people write it here and in a wrong way, by mistake, they write it on the ya. It's not on the ya. The word shay on. Shay on. If you write it like this, then it'll be like sha'un. Tamam? So pay attention to this. If the Hamza is sakina, preceded by kasra, what do we do? Replace that hamza with a ya. Ya maddiya. Ya sakina. And since there is kasra before it, so it becomes a harf mad. Just like when you replace the hamza with an alif, the alif is always harf mad. So we're going to say instead of nabbi, nabbi, hayyi. Tamam? The third time, همزة مفتوحة وصلا بعد فتح. When we're connecting, the همزة is مفتوحة and there is فتحة before it. So we can combine this, by the way, this with number one. We can say, if there's a همزة ساكنة or مفتوحة preceded by فتحة, what do we do? Replace the همزة with an ألف. بدأ, بدأ. ذراء ذراء تمام امرأة امرأة سوء ما كان أبوك امرأة سوء right امرأة امرأة ما كان أبوك امرأة if you need to stop تبرأ تمام فنتبرأ مبوأ أسوأ ملجأ Just like that. The fourth type, Hamza Maftuha, preceded by Kasra. So we do what? The same thing when we did with Hamza Sakina preceded by Kasra. Replace the Hamza with a Ya. Quri'a, Quri. Now, who knows how to read the next word? Who knows how to read this word? How do we read this word? How do you read this word? Say it.
Ustuhzi.
Tamam. Barakallah fiik. Ustuhzi. Tamam. Ustuhzi. In this type, as you can see, we replace the Hamza with a Ya. Ya Maddiya. We replace it with Ya Sakina. And since there is Kasra before it, then it becomes Ya Maddiya. Type number five. Type number five. Hamza Maftuha Waslan. Preceded by حرف صحيح ساكن preceded by سكون okay preceded by سكون or حرف ساكن but that ساكن letter is صحيح means what it's not a mad letter it's not a mad letter right if you look here So here, Hamza Maftuha, Maftuha, preceded by second letter. We don't have yet that Hamza preceded by a second letter yet. Okay? So it has to be a second and sahih as well. Example, only one example in the whole Quran, guys, huh? Al-Khab'a, Al-Khab'a, Yukhriju Al-Khab'a, Khab'a, Khab'a. If we stop on this word, what do we do? Just to drop the Hamza. Basically, it's called نقل حركة الهمزة إلى الساكن صحيح قبلها. Remove, move the Hamza, the حركة of the Hamza to the letter before it and drop the Hamza. So it becomes الخبأ. But we, when you stop, you have to make it second. So al-khad, al-khad, khad, tamam, al-khad. Okay. So this is how you stop on this word. يُخْرِجُ الْخَدْ. And this word, by the way, is an example and a proof to those brothers or teachers who teach students that you do qalqala with a hamza. Al-haqqa wa tab. So we tell them, if you stop on this word in half's narration, how do you stop? You say al-khab, al-khab, right? Yukhriju al-khab. There you're putting a hamza. But why you put a hamza in the qalqala? If you're claiming with the qalqala there is a hamza, then those words like this word al-khab when you stop on it. And that's not right. They're not the same. They're not written the same. So qalqala doesn't have a hamza with it. Qalqala, you just bounce the letter without adding any letter or any haraka or anything. Okay? So, for Imam Ibn Amir, Imam Hisham, when you stop on this word, you're going to drop the hamza. So you're going to say what? Al-khad. Just qalqala for the ba. Al-khad. Clear so far? Yeah. Number six. Hamza maksura waslan. Ba'da sakin sahih. So hamza maftuha preceded by sakin sahih. Now hamza maksura preceded by sakin sahih. And here, like al-mar'i, and here we have two ways. The first way, drop the hamza. Al-mar, drop the hamza. Al-mar, and the ra is heavy. Why? Sakin preceded by fatha. Al-mar, make the mim light. Al-mar, okay? Make the meme light, al-mar, and make the ra heavy, al-mar, mar. The other way is raum, which means what? Part of the kasra, part of the third. Remember, raum, third, raum is third. So part of the kasra, third of the kasra. And who can tell me what will happen in this case for the ra? What will happen for the ra? So the first way is dropping the hamza, al-mar, okay? يَوْمَ يَنْظُرُ الْمَرُ. The second way, رَوْمُ كَسْرَةِ الرَّائِ, means third of the kasra, of the ra. What happens to the ra here? Does it remain heavy? It becomes light. Why becomes light? Because Raum, you're going to treat the letter on which you apply Raum, you're going to treat it as if it has a haraka. Tamam? While in Ishmam, you treat it as if it has sukun. Remember this rule, guys, that we mentioned in Al-Jazariya. So, Al-Mar, when it has third of the kasra, as if it has a kasra, so the ra will be light. Al-Mari, Al-Mari, when it has a kasra, but you should have third of a kasra. يوم ينظر المري مري مري okay not مري 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 okay third of the كسرة مري المري and you make it light. That is the sixth type. The seventh type is همزة مضمومة بعد ساكن صحيح. همزة مضمومة بعد ساكن صحيح. ملء دفء المرء جزء. Here there are three ways. The first way is common in all of these cases. Okay, if the hamza is maftuha or madmuma or maksura. Okay guys, I'm gonna collect them for you inshallah and summarize them for you later on when we're done. If the hamza is مكسورة or مفتوحة or مضمومة preceded by ساكن صحيح. What do we do? What's the common way in all of them? Huh? What's the common way in all of them?
Drop the همزة.
Drop the همزة. So, for example, Al-Khabr. You can say Al-Khabr. Al-Mar'u or Al-Mar'i. Al-Mar. Mil'u. Mil. Dif on. Dif. Lakum fiha dif. Just like that. Drop the Hamza. Dif. Okay? Because yani, the summary is dropping the Hamza. If you want to go to the details, move the haraka of the Hamza to the sakin before it, it becomes difu. Then when you're stopping, it has to be half sukun, so dif. So basically, just drop the Hamza. Okay? Now, when there is a kasra, when there is a kasra, yani, that Hamza is maksura, you can do raum when you stop. You can do what? Raum. Third of the kasra, al-mari. So, but when there is the Hamza maftuha preceded by sakin, in Hamza maftuha, when there's a fatha, can we apply raum? No raum. Can we apply ishmam? No ishmam. So only one way. Tamam? Only one way. When there's no haraka, okay? When there's no dhamma or kasra, you cannot do ishmam or raum. إلا بفتح أو بنصب. In فتح النصب, you cannot do raum or ishmam. That's why there's only one way. Now, when there is kasra, the hamza has kasra, then you can apply what? Can you apply ishmam? No. Ishmam only for the dhamma. So then you can apply raum. So there are two ways. Al-mar'i, you can say al-mar or al-mari with raum. Now, if there is Hamza madmuma preceded by sakin sahih, how many ways will there will be? Three. Drop the Hamza, dif, make raum, difu, right? Al-maru, milu, third of the dhamma. The third way, dif, with ishmam. Because the dhamma, with the dhamma, you can do ishmam. Al-mar, mil. Is that clear? So these are the three ways. Ishmam al-dhamma, rawmuha, and waqf, with dropping the hamza. Juz, this is dropping the hamza. Ishmam, juzu. This is rawm, sorry. Ishmam, juz. Tamam? Is it clear? So, juz. That's ishmam. Mil, dif, that is ishmam. Okay, so this is the seventh type. The eighth type, we're going to take 10 and stop here, inshallah, for today. The eighth type is الهمزة المكسورة وصلاً بعد فتح. مكسورة بعد فتح. We had مكسورة بعد سكون. There are two ways. Drop the همزة and wrong. Now مكسورة بعد فتح. There is فتحة before it. الملأ النبأ حمأ. When we say كسرة or كسرتين. Excuse me. ملجأ نبأ. Here there are two ways. Replace the Hamza with an Alif. Replace the Hamza with an Alif. Al-Mala'i, Al-Mala. An-Naba, Hama, Malja, Naba. The second way is what? Tasheelul Hamza. Ha, Tasheel now. Tasheelul Hamza ma'arrawm. Al-Mala'i, An-Naba'i, Hama'i. حماي ملجأي نبأي okay with روم تسهيل with روم not نبأي إي no نبأي okay نبأي like that تسهيل الهمزة مع روم كسرتها Yalla, we did not practice. I'm gonna let you practice. I'm gonna upload this video when we finish, inshallah. Okay, I'm going to upload this video when we finish. These two videos. I'm not going to have time to put them together. And I'm just going to upload them two separate videos so that you practice. Next class, before we move to the next 10 types, I'm going to let you practice them. Okay, practice those examples and make sure you got them, inshallah. If you don't practice them, there's no benefit of this class. This is the main, the most important part of this class, in which you have to practice so that I make sure you have them right, inshallah. تسهيل الهمزة مع روم كسرتها. So we made tasheel of the hamza with raum of the kasra. النوع التاسع. An exception for the eighth type, which is the word naba itself, but it is written under an alif with aya that is silent after it. With aya that is silent after it. And now you know also why is there a ya there, which is silent in hafs. Tamam? Because in some qira'at you pronounce that ya. Tamam? So, النوع التاسع is this word, which is نبأي, Surah Al-An'am, Ayah 34. And in this case, there are only in this word, huh? Even though it's Hamza Maksura, preceded by Fatha, but there are four ways. Why? Because there's a Ya Sakina after it. Okay? So the first way, drop the Hamza and don't pronounce the Ya. Naba, ala al-qiyas, means the same rule. The second way is what? Tasheel. With Rome also, تسهيل الهمزة مع الروم على القياس, also the same like number 8, which is what? نبأي, 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 okay, نبأي. This is like number 8. What's extra? Who can guess? What is extra? It will be related to the ya. What will happen? We're going to replace the Hamza with the ya. So we're going to say نبي إبدالها ياء مكسورة ثم إسكانها للوقف على الرسم يعني نبي يعني replace the Hamza with a ياء. Okay, نبا إي, just replace the Hamza with a ياء. نبي نبا إي, replace it with ياء ساكنة. Okay, if we replace it with ya maksura and we're gonna stop, all of our talk is about stopping. So basically replace the hamza with ya saki. Okay, nabay, nabay. Now the fourth way, you're gonna do raum of the kasra. Nabay. Now huh? Listen now the difference, huh? Again, this difference came here. It's very slight difference. Here, replace the Hamza with Ya Maksura and do Rome of the Kasra. Nabayi, Nabayi, Yi, huh? Not Yi, 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 Yi. Third of the Kasra. Nabayi, Nabayi, Nabayi. But the difference between number 4 and number 3, number 2 is what? Tasheel Ma'arram. And we mentioned this today in the beginning of the class, right? There, Nabayi. نبأي إي here نبأي إي تمام تسهيل of همزة مع الروم different from ياء مكسورة مع الروم. Is that clear guys? Okay, last type for today إن شاء الله. النوع العاشر الهمزة المكسورة وصلا بعد كسر ومرسومة بالياء. Okay, همزة مكسورة وصلا and there is kasra before it, but it's written under a ya. It's written under a ya. Here we have hamza maksura preceded by fatha, right? Here preceded by kasra. Hamza maksura preceded by kasra. Maksura preceded by kasra. Okay, and that hamza is written under a ya. What are those three ways that we have? We have three ways, practically three ways. The first way, so imri'in shati'in as-sayyi' imri'in. These examples. First way is replace it ya sakina. Okay, shati. إبدالها ياء ساكنة من جنس حركة ما قبلها من جنس حركة ما قبلها يعني من جنس حركة الذي قبلها replace it with ياء ساكنة because the ياء suits the كسرة right شاطي so we're gonna replace it with ياء ساكنة شاطي السي إمري إمري تمام ياء ساكنة ياء ساكنة replace the همزة with ياء ساكنة شاطي السي إمري that's the first way the second way إبدالها ياء مكسورة على الرسم so here على القياس means like the rule that we have been taking right replace the همزة right with a letter that suits its حركة That suits the haraka of the letter before it. And here also that suits its haraka itself. The second way, على الرسم, means based on the way the hamza is written. Based on the way on the hamza is written, there's another way to stop, which is what? Replace the hamza with ya maksura. Okay? Ya maksura. Ya maksura, not sakina. Shatiyi, huh? Shatiyi, but it's kind of because we're stopping, so we're gonna stop. We're gonna make the ya sakina. In that case, number one and number two are the same. Tamam. So that's why I said they say arba'at awjuh taqdiran, yani theoretically four ways, but practically three. You guys got that? So. Number three, إبدال الهمزة ياء مكسورة مع الروم ياء مكسورة شاطي with روم not شاطي شاطي because we cannot stop with a full حركة guys remember either روم or سكون or إشماء السي here replacing as-say-yi, 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 imri, imri, yi, yi, huh? Imri, imri, okay? Finally, at-tas-heel ma'arraw. Again, these two ways very, very close. You have to distinguish between them. Tas-heel al-hamza with rawm. Huh? Tas-heel al-hamza with rawm. So how are we going to do that? Shati, 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 imri, as-sayyi, 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 as-sayyi. Okay? Not as-sayyi in the realm. In the realm, as-say, 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 okay, as-say, that's with realm, with realm, with realm of the ya maksura. But with the tasheel, as-say, 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 e. السيي السيي okay سيي and it's saying e السيي okay clear تسهيل بالروم مع القياس السيي and it's saying e السيي السيي okay تسهيل بالروم مع القياس while replacing it ياء مكسورة with the روم It comes as-say-yi, as-say-yi. With wrong, as-say-yi, as-say-yi. Tamam? As-say-yi, it is as-say-yi-i, as-say-yi-i. when we replace that Hamza with Ya Maksura, okay, it becomes So if we take shati'i, we said shati'i, and replacing it ya maksura shati'i, and then replacing it ya maksura with rom shati'i, and then tasheel shati'i, okay? But with this word, because we have ya with a kasra here, we have to pay attention to it. And also it is mushaddada. So, as-say-yi. The ya is mushaddada. Say-yi, and then the hamza, okay? The first way we said ibdaluha ya an sakinatan. We have a ya here. Okay. So it becomes as-say, and it's saying as-say-yi. Did I say that? If I said other than that, this is how it should be. When we, the first way, as-say-yi. And it's saying as-say-yi, okay? The second way is the same. As-say-yi, because it will be as-say-yi, when we're stopping as-say-yi. So number one, number two are the same. As-say-yi. ولا يحيق المكر السيء. The third way, يا مكسورة مع الروم. السيء يا مكسورة مع الروم. السيء يي ها يي. But with third of the كسر. السيء السيء السيء. Okay. السيء السيء. Okay. سيي. It's a little bit tricky. We're gonna repeat this one inshallah as well next time. Now تسهيلها بالروم. تسهيلها بالروم. تسهيل of this Hamza. مع الروم. السيي. E. No. E. E. With third of the kasr. السيي. السيي السيي تمام والله سبحانه وتعالى أعلم صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا والحمد لله رب العالمين. Is that clear? Is this clear? Do you want me to repeat any of these? Okay, I'm gonna upload them for you to sit, work on them, and let me know inshallah if you have any question, and we're gonna summarize them and let you practice all of them inshallah next time. Sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. ما خلص التسجيل الان.